MovieWeb.com.
In 1975, rock was a man's world.
You dogs will be lucky to get a gig singing in the shower.
Go sell Girl Scout cookies.
Until...
love the movie. This was just a rock and roll, like so much fun. Such a great movie. I want to begin by asking you about the band and sort of the legacy of the Runaways. Obviously, they're an important group to women and to rock and roll. And so, was that sort of what motivated you and made you want to be a part of this film?
Yeah, I mean, definitely. I think also getting to play a real person was a big draw for me. I've never done that before, so I was really excited to do that. And I didn't really know a lot about the Runaways when I first read the script, so I was excited to kind of bring them to a new audience more that are my age. So.
Awesome. Because they really were like the first all-girl band who played like aggressive rock music, and it's nice to know that they actually really did lay the groundwork, because it was a really tough fight, because it wasn't just fun and easy and rock and roll and, like, you know, it was hard.
Yeah. Could you talk a little bit about the relationship between Joan and Sherry? I know it was obviously they started as friends, and it sort of started to erode the relationship and eventually broke up the band. So could you talk a little bit about what that was like to play those characters?
I didn't think that a disintegration of that relationship is what broke the band up at all. It was just a sort of wearing down of Sheree, and then the band actually didn't break up. It seems like they do in the movie, but the Runaways kept going for a little while and you know, ultimately did. But I think what is really cool and triumphant about the movie is that you have two examples of, like, really driven people who know themselves very well, and, or at least by the end, Sheree gets to, she sees that, like, she has to choose a different path, and Joan is, you know, on her own, and she's like, this is her life, this is, like, rock and roll is what she wants to do, and it really fuels her, and I think it's cool to see, like, be just as excited for someone who chose the less, you know, glamorous or successful, seemingly successful route. But I don't think it has anything to do, I don't think they broke up because they weren't, I mean...
No, I think the ultimate reason that Sheree, you know, left is that she just couldn't continue on this path, or she wasn't gonna live much longer, and so she, you know, made that choice, which is really incredible to me. I think that when I really thought about that sacrifice, it really was powerful that she, you know, chose to live like a normal life, you know, over what she loved to do, because she knew she was probably gonna die.
Well, and I know that's so serious. Well, I know Joan Jett was a producer on the film and on the set, and so I was just wondering what she was sort of able to tell you guys about the time and anything, you know, advice you sort of, because you really nail playing her so well in the film. What was she sort of able to help you with that?
It was a help to just have her there and to know that, like, if there was anything that needed to be said, she was going to say it, or anything that she needed to, I don't know, I mean... When you become friends with someone and then you know, you're telling their story and you know that people are going to know them through you, because, I mean, that's an enormous... I mean, of course, like, it was awesome to have her there because she lived it and she is that person, and you can look at a million pictures and look at a million videos, but you don't necessarily capture an essence. And so I'm glad she was there. You've been waiting for hello, Daddy.
We were the first girls to rock, and we did it the only way we knew how, on our own.